safety protection. And I came here for some little shopping. Today being Sunday, I found some time behind me. If you will have a look, you can see the shawarma corner. Here you get both beef and chicken. People say that the taste is too good here. Anybody who would love to.
And if you are a vegetarian, you need to be very specific to him about your choice. And the making is in progress. This is nothing new that I'm going to share with you. It's just to, you know, show you how things are made here. The red hot chili paste is coated on the inner layer of the kobos or the bread. And now few pieces of cabbage and some potato fries are added to it. In between, I could also manage to have a few words with Jamil, the expert shawarma maker.
Habibi, your name?
Jamil.
So this is Jamil with us, the expert shawarma maker.
I have heard about people talking great about this place for its taste and prices. I could see many people placing their orders before entering into the supermarket and take their food away while going back. Shawarma is made by alternately stacking strips of fat and pieces of seasoned meat on a vertical spit. The meat is roasted slowly on the flame for hours. So this is the final stage of preparation in which the shawarma is roasted, fried or grilled. You can see the different types of shawarma they can make and the prices are really okay. So the next time if you visit this place, say a hello to Jamil. He sounded to be a cool guy. The morning weather was somehow pleasant, overcast. All of a sudden rain picked up and I thought of having some hot boiled corn, something suitable to the weather. Mama seemed to bother less the rain and was busy in selling. I was admiring her determination.
Yes, sir.
I ended up paying more than what she asked me to. That was the least little thing I could do at that moment.
Weekends are always full of fun, you all know that. And here Saturdays are mostly spent on, you know, buying household items.
So the weekend schedule continues. I am now pushing off to a place called Ilupeju.
Have a look at this vegetable shop owned by a local business owner. Here you get all sorts of vegetables that we normally get in our home country.
From the display itself, you can get a rough idea of what kind of vegetables are available here. Again, this is for people who have always asked me, what food items do we get here in Nigeria?
This is a section of a supermarket where you can actually see all sorts of Indian pulses, grains, spices and other stuffs available.
Again, this is for people who have always asked me, what food items do we get here? And I hope this little information convinces you.
So generally what happens is during weekends, after all the purchases or whatever are done, people tend to visit or go to some malls just to, you know, have some relaxation. They go for a movie. But now that all these places are still under lockdown, there is no opportunity for others to, you know, venture out there. We are hoping that things would fall back in shape over a period of time. Till then, we need to be safe and sound. So that's all from my side now in this episode. Thanks for watching. We'll get back to you soon with some more interesting stories.